All right, let me make this quick because I just turned off all of my fans in this room and it is about to get absolutely sweltering in here. But hello, my name is Christopher Ha, and if you don't know who I am basically the producer of these videos. I do the bulk of the post-production work, I film and edit all of them, and I headed up a live stream for the Poetry Slam. You may have seen me around. In this episode, you may notice there are a lot of Valentine's references. That is for a reason. We filmed this episode and all of its content around Valentine's Day. And due to circumstances, we just couldn't release it until now. But please ignore all of the old references and old event announcements and enjoy the episode.
Today on Trinity News.
It's Valentine's Day again, and we're still both very,
very
single.
Well, in school news, the National Latin Exam is coming up, since we know everyone is super excited to take another standardized test.
So excited. Also, Pascal Music Night is coming up soon. It'll be a little different this year, so be sure to keep an eye out for details.
That's right, and speaking of great things to listen to, we now have two more school-produced podcasts. Dr. Mrs. Scholl came out with the Dorothy L. Sayers podcast, season 2, and House Pascal came out with The Blazes, both of which can be found on Spotify.
That's all for news today. And now, here's a presentation from a poet who's very excited about Valentine's Day.
Singleness is joyful. Singleness is fun. Singleness is affordable, but it's not for everyone. If you're single, you'll live on your own. No one to bug you, because you're all alone. No one to call you to make you go out. No one to cheat on you. No one to doubt. Singleness is great. No plans to postpone. Eating out is cheaper when you're all on your own.
Thank you for that inspiring poem, Nathan.
That's right. And now it's time for something intellectual.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Patrick, and this is Something Intellectual, Valentine's Day edition. So my favorite Valentine's Day date was the most expensive Valentine's date I ever had. It was my husband and I, it was our very first Valentine's Day together, and since we went on our first date in the beginning of January, we'd only been dating for about 6 weeks. And he had gone on a duck hunting trip with some of his friends, and he returned with ducks, which was amazing. And so I helped to cook the ducks, and then we began to eat the ducks. And one, the ducks were disgusting. I don't know if you've ever had wild ducks, but they only eat algae, and so their muscles taste like liver. So we're eating these liver-flavored ducks that were really nasty. And second, they had a ton of buckshot in them. Buckshot? Do we call it buckshot when it's not shot into a buck? Birdshot. There you go. Had a ton of these little tiny beads of pellets embedded into the muscles where they had been shot. And so we were constantly spitting like beads onto our plates. So it was already a very torturous experience. And then during the meal, my husband, my then boyfriend, revealed to me that he had been hunting without a license. And I don't know if you realize this or not, but ducks are federally protected birds. And he and his friends thought that it was okay to go out without a license this one time. And luckily, when the game warden approached them, they didn't have any dead birds on their persons. Because if they were found with dead birds on their persons, it would have been a $10,000 per carcass fine. But because they didn't have any birds on them, they were fined $1,000 each and then had to take a 30-hour hunting training course. So my then boyfriend paid, I think, $2,000 for our duck dinner and then had to attend 30 hours of hunting training. So it was at that point that I realized that being an adult is complicated. And if you try to break the rules, sometimes you get caught. And also, my husband, my boyfriend at the time, was a very upright citizen who admitted his mistakes and took his lumps. And then also, we ate a not delicious, but very expensive Valentine's Day meal together.
Well, that's all the time we have for today.
And don't forget, you can email us at tcs.trinity@gmail.com with any ideas you may have for upcoming episodes.
Thank you so much for watching.
And see you next time on Trinity.